Everybody wants to get top dollar when selling their home, so we are turning to Elena Falco. She is the owner of Realty Executives Legacy. So happy to have you on the show today.
Thank you for having me.
You are definitely a pro when it comes to getting that top dollar. So when you're going for upgrades, what's really working right now?
Well, always kitchen and baths. So if you're going to put money into your house, I always tell people if they can afford it to do the kitchen, then the bathrooms. That's where you're going to get the most money for your house. A lot of people can't necessarily afford to put money into their kitchens and baths because they are high ticket items. So if you can't do that, you kind of want to make your house work for you. Lower the price of the house in order to accommodate for the fact that maybe you haven't done those improvements. I always also tell my sellers if there's something that easy things that you can do that don't cost a lot of money. Painting is a very, very good thing. A fresh coat of paint goes a long way. Your flooring. Buyers are looking for the newest flooring trends, and there's some really affordable options out there. You have LVT tile, which is luxury vinyl tile, which you can find at a really economical price for sunrooms and foyers and basements that really can add a lot of value without a lot of costs. Also, cost does not equate value. I have a lot of times I'll have a buyer or a seller come to me and say, I spent $80,000 on my kitchen. Unfortunately, cost does not equate value. So you have to watch what you're spending and try to get the most bang for your buck.
Right, it's smart spending. So let's just take a kitchen or a bath area. So specifically, what do you do that's really working here? Is it granite? Is it quartz? Or
I would say any good solid surface. I'm seeing a lot of white on white. So white.
Oh, that's back.
Yeah, white on white on white. So I'm seeing white kitchens with white countertops with white backsplashes. And basically a light gray, a light French gray wall, it's always a sure hit.
Now, when you're also doing the bathroom per se, what's going there then?
Bathrooms, they can vary depending on whether you're doing a master bath or a powder room. A lot of times people will take into account doing the tile work, which is important, but the expense in bathrooms is all the plumbing and your fixtures, so that can add up pretty fast. Mm-hmm. So you want to, run your numbers because you do have to hire a licensed plumber to install plumbing fixtures, typically. Some homeowners can do it themselves, but it's always best to hire a plumber to take care of those items. I'm seeing a lot of pebble floors, a lot of wood, like their faux wood, ceramic top, porcelain or ceramic tile on the flooring. Clean lines. I'm seeing a lot of clean lines that people are putting in. Mm. Everything's kind of, more of a gray and a white. Now, grays have kind of peaked in color.
That's what I was going to ask you. What colors are big right now?
Gray is really big, but we're kind of at a 10-year high on grays.
Right, I was wondering about that. It's been around for a while.
It's been around for a while, and usually when a color peaks, you see it kind of drift off, and then a new color will come in. We're seeing the navy blues are coming. Those have become pretty strong. Even in cabinetry, we're seeing painted woods of navy blue, eucalyptus green. Another color which I'm not a huge fan of is orange. We're seeing orange, not necessarily go paint your house orange, but accent colors throughout. You're seeing it in fashion, you're seeing it in housing trends.
All good information. Thanks so much for coming on the show today.
No problem. Thank you for having me.
Check out businessfirstam.com to find out where to see our entire show. And don't forget to like, follow, and share Business First AM.